Ah, nostalgia. It is a name that we're very much familiar with that resonates with us in our past and in our future. And for me, nostalgia has three key factors: cartoons, anime, and video games. And thanks to the good old folks from Wave Corporation, they created my all-time favorite side-scroller tank from the Metal Slug series. Hey, what's going on, dudes and dudettes, and welcome to my first mini-review of the SV-001i Metal Slug tank. Let's get to it. So, what's inside this box? Very little, but at the same time, this is a small kit, so that's expected. The manual itself is like between 10 to 8 pages, and you give a brief introduction if you want to do some custom painting on the back. You get the parts, you get some stickers, that's pretty much it. But for those who want to go the extra step, here's a basic breakdown on the tools as well as the paints that I use for this kit. And there you have it, in its sweet, miniature, grindy, dirty, weathery, looking little beast of it is. Sorry, I love this kit a lot. It was a lot of fun. Okay, so let's dive into what makes this kit really, really special, and at the same time, an absolute must-have. Right off the bat, this guy is really small, so you can obviously see it fits in the palm of my hand. But the amount of love and craftsmanship that went into making this kit is absolutely fantastic. They did need to go that extra step, but they did. Everything down to the Gatling guns, to the little exhaust ports, as well as the vent areas, and just love it. Overall, love it. And there's just like tons and tons of room of creativity when you build this. Now, as for movable parts, there are two areas that I felt that it was needed, and they did it, probably to cut down on costs. The cannon moves up and down, which is totally fine, and a little bit of left and right, but you don't want to move it too much to the point where you will break it. Second area that you can actually do some kind of form movement are the dual machine guns, so you can sway them left and right, and in any kind of comfortable position that you want that you feel that would look nice. Now, the downside, the tank treads, once again I state that they probably did this to cut down on costs. It doesn't hurt the kit at all. If anything, it's probably better for them to stay stationary because you don't want to lose all those little parts. Now, if memory serves me correctly, there is another variant of this tank from another model company. I don't know the name right off the top of my head, but it helps create that nice little niche to having the tank treads move. It's a little bit more expensive. I think it goes like around $50 to $60 depending on who sells it on eBay or Amazon. This kit, I got it for like around $50 on eBay. But if you look for it on Amazon, I think it goes like around $80 due to the fact that they don't mass produce these guys anymore. So if you're a diehard fan, you love Neo Geo games, you love little tanks, you want a little tank in your game collection, pick this little guy up. You don't have to do any crazy painting or weathering. Just to have that little memorabilia in your collection brings everything together. It's a must buy. Get it. And like that, guys, we are done. Thanks a ton for watching this video. Please stay tuned for next month where I'll have another little mini review or perhaps another speed build for you guys to view. Until then, my name is Otaku Builder, and I'll see you next time.